A very good morning to all of you children. Let us continue with lesson number 8, Microsoft Excel. Children, in the previous turn, we have done the introduction of MS Excel. Today, we are going to do uses of MS Excel. Microsoft Excel or MS Excel is the most popular spreadsheet program which is used to manipulate numeric data. Children, if you want to write the numeric data, Excel sheet is the best sheet for you. You can write all the numeric data very easily and you can do lots of sorting. The first one is for manipulating numbers. Children, if you have written the numeric data, you can manipulate it very easily. You can use Excel to quickly tally your marks in exams, calculate averages of your total marks, etc. You can also use Excel to perform any kind of mathematical calculations. The second important use is organize data. We like to organize everything, isn't it, children? So, you can organize your data in the row and the column format. I have already shown you the rows and the column, and it is very easy to enter the data and organize it. The third use is store data as workbooks. In Excel, you can store data which you enter in it as a file called workbook. Excel 2010 workbooks are stored using .xlsx file extension. Children, this file extension name is very important. Within each workbook, you can store numerous individual worksheets to hold your data. So, in each workbook, you can have number of worksheets. And what is the file extension name? It is .xlsx. The fourth one is to share data. If you want to share with the users, you can share the data very easily. You can import data from other sources and can export data into other file formats. So, to share your data with others, you can also save your data as PDF or HTML file. Children, let us see the features of MS Excel. The first and the most important feature is edit and format data. Whatever you are writing, you can edit it, you can format it very easily. Excel allows you to efficiently enter, edit, that means any change or format data in a worksheet. You can easily edit it. You can easily format the whole data. You can quickly enter a series of numbers that I have already done it in the previous class. Find and replace data or check data for spelling errors. You can also make data stand out in a worksheet by adding borders. So, children, you can add borders or change the font. As you can do in the Word, you can do it in MS Excel also. You can change the font, color, style, or alignment of the data. The second most important feature is using the formulas and functions. Children, you can do lots of calculation using MS Excel. It is basically for calculation only. Common calculation include finding the sum, average, or total number of values in the list. As you work, Excel checks your formulas for problems and can help you correct common errors in your formulas. Children, the third important feature is to print the worksheet. Children, you can easily print the worksheet, whatever work you have done. You can take out the hard copy of it. Before printing, you can see the actual screen or the paper which will come out, how it will look. Excel also allows you to adjust the margins or change the size of the printed data. Create charts and objects. As you can create charts in the Word, you can also create charts in the Excel. Excel helps you to create colorful charts from worksheet data to visually display the data. You can also add objects such as auto shapes, word art, and diagrams. It will enhance the overall look of your chart. Now, starting off MS Excel. To start the Excel, follow these steps. Click on the Start button. The Start menu will appear. Click on All Programs. Click on Microsoft Office. Click on the Microsoft Excel 2010 and MS Excel workbook will appear in front of you. Now, children, the most important thing which we are going to learn is the Excel window. When you will start the MS Excel, you will see this type of window. This is called Excel window. The main features, or you can say the main labeling, have been done here. Name box. This is the name box. This is the formula box, or you can say formula bar. This is the actual worksheet window where you work. These are the column headings. These are the row headings. And this is called a cell. These are the toolbars. Children, there are some more important components of this window, and we are going to study all the components in detail. When you open the Excel program, a blank workbook is displayed, and you will see that it is named as Book 1. The first and the topmost bar in front of you will be the title bar, as it is in case of Word also. It shows the name of the opened workbook file. Now the file tab. You already know where is the file tab. A backstage view appears, which resembles in a backstage view. You will find a list of commands like save, open, print, etc. in the file tab. Quick access toolbar, you already know because these things are very familiar to you and you have already studied in MS Word. In quick access toolbar, you will get save, undo, redo commands. Now the ribbon displays the related commands in tabs, and each tab offers the shortcut buttons to the common task. Formula bar. In this, it is used to enter or edit formulas and perform calculation on your worksheet data. Then comes the window control buttons. Again, you know it is the same as we have done it in MS Word. You can restore it, you can make it full size, or you can close the window. Worksheet window. The workbook contains sheets called worksheets. By default, workbook contains three worksheets, which I have already shown you in the previous video. You can also add additional worksheets. Each sheet has a name displayed on the sheet tab at the bottom of the workbook. And what will be the name given? Sheet 1, Sheet 2, Sheet 3. Row and column headings. You already know the vertical is the columns and horizontal is the row. So a column letter above the grid, also called the column heading, and it identifies each column, and a row on the left side of the grid, which is numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, it identifies each row. Now a cell. The box which appear in front of you, it is called a cell. A cell is called the intersection of each column and row in a worksheet. A cell is the basic unit of the worksheet into which you enter the data. Now, what is active cell? Active cell, wherever you are writing. Active cell has a dark border around it. The active cell is in the picture A1. The next component is cell reference. Children, in the previous turn, I have told you how you can address the cell. This is the unique address or the cell reference. You can see in the grid C6. So, in the table where you will see C6, so it is the unique address of that cell. Name box, it is the cell reference of an active cell is displayed in the name box. Grid lines. Children, you can see the horizontal and the vertical lines representing the rows and the columns on the worksheet. These lines are called grid lines. The grid line allow us to see and identify each cell within a worksheet. You can see the mouse pointer. Here, the mouse pointer is block plus sign. Wherever you will move the finger, you will see the block plus sign is also moving with the finger. Actually, this is the mouse pointer. Another common shape of the mouse pointer is the black arrow. The mouse turns into a black arrow whenever you move it outside the worksheet or when you drag the cell contents between the rows and columns. Children, the next important component is scroll bar. Children, you all know that we can see a limited portion on the screen. If you want to see beyond it, you have to use the scroll bars to look at the right hand side or downwards. Split box. To the right of the sheet tab at the bottom of the screen is the tab split box. You can drag the tab split box to increase or decrease the view of the sheet tabs. Now, the lastly is the status bar. Status bar is located at the bottom of the worksheet window that displays the process of the current task and controls for viewing the worksheets. Children, status bar is the same bar which you have done it in MS Word. I hope, children, you have understood all the uses, features, and the basic components of MS Excel. Thank you, children.